Hello friends, welcome back to my channel Chemistry Unplugged. Today we will discuss about symmetry elements in chiral molecules and R and S nomenclatures with lots of example. So please subscribe to my channel and click on bell icon for future notifications. So first is optical activity. Optical activity of a compound can be determined by chiral center or stereo center. If a molecule has chiral or stereo center, it is optically active. And we know that a chiral center is a center which is attached with four different groups. When a carbon is attached with four different groups, we consider that it is chiral. But it is not always true. So, according to the modern definition, a molecule should not have symmetry elements like center of symmetry, plane of symmetry, and improper axis of symmetry. So, a molecule should not have following symmetries to be chiral. First is center of symmetry, then plane of symmetry, and last is alternative axis of symmetry or improper axis of symmetry. If a molecule has any of one of these, then it will be achiral. So to be chiral, it should not have these symmetry elements. So first is center of symmetry. A molecule has center of symmetry if all the straight lines that can be drawn through the center of molecule meet the identical atom at equal distance from the center. So it is not easy to understand from the definition. So let's take an example to understand it. Suppose we have this molecule. It is a cyclobutane molecule which is attached with two chlorine atoms and two fluorine atoms at opposite carbons. So we have to identify that if it has had a center of symmetry, then we draw a straight line that can be passes through the center and meet the identical atoms at equal center, equal distances. This is center, and if we draw a line which passes through this hydrogen and we draw this line through the center and it meets again a hydrogen at equal distance from the center, then this is center of symmetry. Similarly, it has this chlorine is from the equal distance of center and this is also from the equal distance. Similar for this fluorine atom and this fluorine atom. If we draw a line through this center, it passes through the center and meets with another fluorine atom. Two identical atoms from the equal distance of the center. So it has a center of symmetry denoted by Ci. It means this molecule is optically inactive. Next is plane of symmetry. Means imaginary plane passing through a molecule which can bisect the molecule into two equal halves. So what is the meaning of this? Suppose we have water molecule. This is the structure of water molecule, somewhat tetrahedral. So when we draw a plane passing through the oxygen atom, it can divide the molecule into two equal halves containing one hydrogen on both sides. So it is a plane, it is vertical plane. And if we draw another plane which bisects the molecule in the horizontal plane, it is a horizontal plane which bisects the molecule into two equal halves. It is molecular axis, the plane in the molecular axis, and it can bisect the molecule into two equal halves. Therefore, it also has a vertical plane of symmetry and horizontal plane of symmetry. Similarly, let's take an organic molecule. It is mesotartaric acid. And from this structure, you may think that it has a chiral carbon because it is attached with four different groups. OH, H, COH, and the whole group, this one. Okay, so it can have two chiral carbons, but and because it has two chiral carbon, it can show optical activity, but it has a plane of symmetry which can divide the molecule into two equal halves. Therefore, this molecule is optically inactive. That is why I am saying that attaching with four different groups is not only criteria to identify optical activity. You have to consider symmetry elements also. So it is not optically active. Another molecule is this in which carbon is attached with methyl hydrogen and two chlorine atom. So you can say that it doesn't have any plane of symmetry, but if you can look it in three-dimensional view, then hydrogen is below the plane methyl is above the plane and these two chlorine groups are in the plane of the paper. One is on the upward side and the other one is on the lower side. So if we draw a plane which can meet with hydrogen, methyl and carbon, then this plane can bisect the molecule into two equal halves and one chlorine atom is on the upper side of the half and second chlorine atom is on the lower side of the half. So in this way, this molecule is divided into two equal halves, means it has a plane of symmetry and it is also an optically inactive molecule. Third is alternative axis of symmetry. Alternating axis of symmetry. When a molecule is rotated through theta degree about an axis passing through it and then reflected in a plane vertical to the axis of rotation is said to have alternating axis of symmetry, S and SN. Let's take an example. Means we have this molecule and it is quite complex molecule, so you may think that it can show optical activity because nitrogen is attached with four different groups and it can show optical activity. But we have to check whether it has an alternating axis of symmetry. So what we have to do, how we can apply alternating axis of symmetry, it will be clear to you that first you have to rotate this molecule. So you have to rotate it by theta degree. So suppose we are using an axis which is passing through the nitrogen in this way and we are rotating this molecule by 90 degree. So what will happen after rotation, because this whole group on the above side of nitrogen is above the plane, this one is above the plane and the backward side is below the plane. So after rotation, this whole ring will be in the plane and the lower side which was in the plane will come, one side will become above the plane, other side will become below the plane. So this is the situation after rotation, and because we rotate it by 90 degree, therefore this is C4 axis. Okay, C4 is a simple axis of rotation, and because we divide 360 by 90, that we get the value 4. Then we will reflect it through the plane which is perpendicular to the axis and we get the molecule, this one. This side will become here, and in this way, this whole molecule is similar to the starting one. Because these two structures are same, means it has an alternating axis of symmetry. When we apply a symmetry element to a molecule, the molecule should get the original position or should be superimposed. Then we can call that it has that particular symmetry element. So symmetry S4 is sum of C4 and reflection through the plane perpendicular to it. So in this way, it is also optically inactive because it has improper axis of symmetry or alternating axis of symmetry. Next, I give you two examples and you have to identify which one is optically active or not. So in the one, we have two chlorine atom above the plane, and in the second one, one chlorine is above the plane and other is below the plane. So what you have to do, first you can write it like this, Cl on the above side, H on the below side, and similarly Cl on the above side and H on the below side. So we can divide this molecule through a plane and this plane can divide it into two equal halves. It means it has plane of symmetry and it will not be optically active. And for the second molecule, one Cl is above side and second is below side. So we cannot bisect this molecule into two equal halves by a plane. So it is chiral and show optical activity. Next is R and S nomenclature. It is also known as Kahn-Ingold-Prelog system of nomenclature. So you have to follow certain rules to determine RS nomenclature of a optically active molecule. So according to this, four atoms attached to a chiral center are different and priorities are given on the basis of atomic mass. Means that if we have a molecule like this, which is attached with four different groups, one is hydrogen, second is methyl suppose, and third is Cl, fourth is Br. So we have to number these atom, directly attached atom, on the basis of their atomic mass. So Br is given highest priority because its atomic mass is highest. Second is Cl. Third is carbon. Its atomic mass is 12. So it is given 3. And then is 4 is given to hydrogen, which is lowest atomic mass. So Br has highest atomic mass, then chlorine, then carbon, and last for the hydrogen. So we will give number 1 to the highest atomic mass atom. We will give it number 1. And for lowest atomic mass, we will give number 4. That is last, lowest priority. And then we have to rotate the molecule according to the priority rule. And if it is following the clockwise, anti-clockwise order, then it will be S. It will give designation S. We will give it designation S. And when it is clockwise, we will give it designation R. Then for isotopes, if we have hydrogen and deuterium, then we will give priority to deuterium in preference to hydrogen because deuterium has higher atomic mass. Similarly, we have chlorine 37 and chlorine 35. So we will give priority to chlorine 37 because it has higher atomic mass. The second rule is, if directly attached atoms are same, then next atom is considered. So what is the meaning of this? If we have methyl and ethyl group, so both of them have first directly attached atom is carbon, is same for both of them. So we have to consider second atom. So in case of methyl, carbon is attached with hydrogens, and for ethyl, carbon is attached with other carbon and hydrogens. So we will give priority to the ethyl group because it is attached with carbon is attached with higher atomic mass atom. Suppose we have this molecule, so we will number it according to priority rule. We will give chlorine 1 number because it has highest atomic mass, so we will give it number 1. Then other 3 groups have similar atom directly attached with chiral carbon. All of them have carbon, so we have to consider second. So in case of this, it is attached with chlorine, we will give it number 2. Then one group is isopropyl, other is ethyl. So in the isopropyl, carbon is attached with 2 carbons, and in ethyl, carbon is attached with carbon and hydrogen. So we will give priority to the isopropyl group, and last priority is given to ethyl group. And then we will rotate the molecule accordingly. Third rule is, in case of double and triple bonds, atoms are considered in duplicate and triplicate manner respectively. What is the meaning of this? If we have aldehyde CHO group, means C double bond O and C triple bond N. So in case of C double bond O, we will consider it as C O and O. It is attached in this way. And for C triple bond N, we have to triplicate nitrogen. So carbon is attached with 3 nitrogens and nitrogen is attached with 3 carbons. We have to consider it like this and follow the priority rule. Then vinyl group take priority over isopropyl group. CH double bond CH2 is vinyl group, and CH CH3 whole twice is isopropyl group. So we will give priority to the vinyl group. Fifth rule is, lone pair of electrons is considered to have 0 atomic mass and given lowest priority. If a molecule has lone pair of electron, mostly in case of nitrogen compounds, then we will give lone pair of electron lowest priority. Next, how we can apply these rules in wedge projection? In wedge projection, lowest priority group should be on the back side or below the plane to identify the R and S nomenclature. Means lowest priority group should always be on the below side. For example, in this case, this is a molecule. So first we will apply priority rule. Chlorine is given number 1. ethyl is given number 2 and methyl is given number 3. Hydrogen, lowest atomic mass given number 4. So, it is following the rule that lowest priority group on the backside or below the plane. So, we can simply determine the R and S for this type of situation. So, 1 and V move from the side of lowest priority group. We will not move from the side of 3. Otherwise, we will give number 1 and after we will go to 3. So, this will be the wrong way. So, we have to move from lowest priority group side. So, it is following the clockwise pattern. So, it has R configuration. In Fisher projection, lowest priority group should be on vertical line. So, what is the Fisher projection? Suppose it is a two-dimensional way of representing chiral molecules. So, the lowest priority group should be on the vertical line to use R and S nomenclature. So, in the Fisher projection, actually, the vertical line groups are on the below side or out of the view, and horizontal line groups are above the plane. Means H and OH are towards the viewer and CHO and CH2OH are away from the viewer side. So, for the R and S nomenclature, the lowest priority group should be on the vertical line. But in this case, hydrogen, which is the lowest priority group, is on the horizontal line. So, what you have to do if these rules are not following means in the wedge projection, lowest priority group is not on the below side, or in the Fisher projection, lowest priority group is not on the vertical line, then we have to follow single swap rule for the wedge projection. For the wedge projection, in this case, hydrogen is not on the back side. Okay? It is above the plane. So, we have to number it first. And lowest priority group is not on the below side. So, we have to follow the single swap rule. What is the single swap rule? According to single swap rule, we have to swap lowest priority group with the group which is on the below side or below the plane side. We will swap it with C2H5. So, hydrogen will go below the plane and C2H5 will come above the plane. Now, we will number it and determine the configuration. So, it is in the clockwise direction, that is, it has R configuration. But because we have done a single swap, therefore, we have to reverse the configuration. Means the actual configuration will be S. So, in the single swap rule, you have to remember that first you have to do a single swap of lowest priority group, then you have to reverse the configuration to get the true answer. Okay. Similarly, for the Fisher projection, when lowest priority group is not on the vertical line, so you have to simple number the molecule first. We will number it according to the priority rule and determine the configuration. So, according to this, it has S configuration, but because the lowest priority group is not on the vertical line, therefore, we have to reverse the order. That is, it has R configuration. So, you have to remember these situations that lowest priority group should be on the vertical line and on the below the plane. If this situation is not followed, then use single swap rule for wedge projection and reverse the configuration, and for Fisher projection, determine the configuration first and then reverse it. So, we will take here few examples. It will be more clear to you after doing these examples. First, this is a chiral carbon because it is attached with 4 different groups. So, we will number it according to the priority rule. We will give nitrogen first. Then this carbon is attached with oxygen, we will give it number 2. This carbon is attached with other carbons, so we will give it number 3. We will give number 3 and methyl is given 4 number. So, because the lowest priority group is on the below side of the paper or backward side, then we have to not bother about the single swap rule and we just determine the configuration. Because it is anti-clockwise, therefore it has S configuration. In next example, this is the chiral carbon attached with OH ME, and this carbon is attached with, we will give it number 1, and because this carbon is attached with 3 hydrogen, this is attached with carbon which is attached with oxygen, double bond oxygen, and this carbon is attached with oxygen which is attached with single bond oxygen. So we will give it priority 2, then this is given number 3, and this one is 4. Lowest priority group on the backward side, simply determine the configuration. It is clockwise, therefore it has R configuration. Then this carbon is chiral carbon, so determine the priorities. So lowest priority group is not on the below the side, so we have to do single swap with OH. So after the single swap, this will be the situation. Hydrogen is on the below side and OH takes the position of hydrogen. Now we will use priority rule, and this is anti-clockwise, therefore it has S configuration, but because we use a single swap, therefore we have to reverse the configuration. It has R configuration. Next is, it is a Fischer projection and hydrogen is on the vertical line, means it is below the plane. So, and it has 2 chiral carbons. So you have to simply apply priority rule. 1 is given to OH, 2 is given this group, 3 and 4 is given to hydrogen. So it is following the anti-clockwise. So this carbon has S configuration. And for this carbon, we again have anti-clockwise, and this is S configuration. Therefore it is 2S, 3S configuration. Next is the example of tartaric acid, and the lowest priority group, it has 2 chiral carbons, and the lowest priority groups means 2 hydrogens are on the horizontal plane. So first we will simply use priority rule, and determine the configuration. Because it is following the anti-clockwise order, it is S, and in case of this carbon, it is again anti-clockwise, therefore it is also S. But because lowest priority groups are on the horizontal lines, therefore we have to reverse the order, and both of them will have R configuration. Therefore it has 2R and 3R configuration. So that's it. I will end my today's video here. Thank you so much for watching my videos. Please subscribe to my videos and share it with your friends. Press the bell icon for future notifications. Thank you.